Hello from the southwest of China and welcome to the capital of Sichuan province, the megacity of Chengdu, home to an incredible 21 million people. And it'll be our backdrop for the next 11 days of sporting drama wherever you're watching around the world. A warm welcome to you from me, Alec Wilkinson. And I can promise this opening ceremony will be loud, colourful, very Chinese. Big drums and your firework as well. We're at the Dong'an Lake Sports Park Stadium. This city is so vast and has so many facilities. The stadium's actually only being used for the opening ceremony. 45 venues in total being used for these university games. And inside the stadium, we're almost ready to begin. It's been a glorious day in Chengdu after days of heavy rain and grey skies. This morning dawned clear with some glorious sunshine. Very hot tonight though. It's almost 8 o'clock here at the Dong'an Lake Sports Park Stadium in Chengdu and it's still 33 degrees and there's not a breath of breeze. First look inside the Dong'an Lake Sports Park Stadium, where rehearsals have been underway all day, and where we await some very special guests. The stadium was actually completed in 2021, ready for the original start date. Of this
女士们,先生们,
COVID got in the
way.
So here we are
中华人民共和国主席习近平阁下和夫人彭丽媛女士国际大学生体育联合会代理主席雷诺艾娥先生入场.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the People's Republic of China, His Excellency Xi Jinping, Madam Peng Liyuan, and the Vice Acting President, Mr. Leon Adar.
Thank you. official ceremony with the flags and the anthems and of course the athletes parade for that. And then we'll finish off with some cultural shows and entertainment to wrap things up over the next 90 minutes or so. Bird and the sun, and that's where we've begun. The flames of the sun inside the stadium setting off the fireworks. Stadium shook to the noise of those fireworks.
Ladies and gentlemen, the national flag of the People's Republic of China.
Mountainous area of southwestern Sichuan, the Hongduan mountain range. The opening ceremony, very much a celebration of local culture as well as Chinese culture.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national flag and anthem of the People's Republic of China. Please be seated.
So third time lucky for these games, postponed twice because of COVID. We are underway, and it's the third time China's hosted the Fizhou Summer Universiade. Beijing and Shenzhen have been host cities as well. They're very proud that they have two international airports here in Chengdu. I believe there are only two other cities in the country that has two. They're also very proud of their silk and brocade. The game's mascot. So here come student athletes from 115 countries and regions. The real stars of the show, the athletes have come from all around the world then to challenge themselves across 18 sports. Out first, Albania. Albania's two athletes, Liridona Rekshaj and Sadush Tuzuni, both aged 23, and they have the onerous task of being the first out in front of this huge crowd. There they are, both competing in table tennis, which is of course one of the home country's biggest sports, so they really are stepping out into the lion's den here in Chengdu. Albania, who's competed regularly at the Fizhou Summer Games since 1995. Now the lighting on the path that the athletes are walking on, and you can see it very well from inside the stadium, it looks like it's a track made of traditional brocade for them to walk along. And those name placards, the country placards, also decorated in brocade. Sichuan, the province that we're in, of course, was important in the development of the historic Silk Road that connected east and west. Our third team out, fourth team out now, Argentina. Now, you normally get one flag bearer for each team. Yesterday it was decided that they could have two. And so we've got lots of extra flag bearers here tonight as Armenia makes its way out. A mainstay of the Summer Games since the 1993 edition in Buffalo, USA. Armenia are here with 13 athletes across a good spread of sports, 7 in total for the Armenian athletes. Well, this certainly isn't the biggest team Australia have sent to the FISU Summer Games. 105 students have come to Chengdu, though, and represent a huge range of universities. Swinburne Uni, Deakin Uni, University of Wollongong in New South Wales, Melbourne, Adelaide, Monash University, to name just a few on the list. Austria has only missed 3 FISU Summer Games since the very first edition, 64 years ago. Azerbaijanis have represented their universities at the Games since 1993, with another 94 taking part here in Chengdu, including 2 competitors competing in Wushu, which is translated as martial art. It's one of the 3 optional sports added to the programme by the Chinese organisers, and if you've never watched it, give it a go. We'll be covering all the major Wushu bouts for you right here on whatever channel it is you're following us on right now. Five athletes have come to Chengdu from Barbados. A few more from Burundi. And remember, the teams out in the stadium right now during the parade are always going to look bigger than the actual athletes taking part, because their coaches quite rightly get a chance to parade with them. Just the 5 athletes from Belgium, 3 fencers and 2 competing in Taekwondo. Samba time. There are a lot of Brazilian students here. 163 competing. Basketball, athletics, swimming and athletics make up the biggest numbers in the team. Brazil, an ever-present force at these Summer Games. They haven't missed an edition since the very first Games in Turin in 1959. Well, the last few opening ceremonies of university games have seen DJ sets during the parade. So it's a refreshing change to see a live traditional band. Both athletes from Brunei competing in Wushu. Five Bulgarian athletes are here, all of them representing National Sports Academy Vasil Levski. Cape Verde Islands. We were playing a game earlier today at one of the venues trying to name all the flags. There are some really exotic flags, some really colourful flags. The FISU Games, the second largest international multi-sport event after the Olympic Games. It's that big. And Croatia hasn't missed a FISU Summer Games since 1993. And this year they've sent 12 athletes to compete across four sports: athletics, artistic and rhythmic gymnastics, and taekwondo. Making the most of their time in the spotlight, 19 athletes representing Cyprus across five sports. Eight of them actually study outside Cyprus at universities as far afield as Colorado in the US and Bath in the United Kingdom. Well, a much bigger contingent from the Czech Republic, 135, 27 of them competing in basketball. Thirteen athletes, all but two of them in the Danish team are female. Jonas Bjerremund, one of the male athletes from Aarhus University. And the Ecuadorian flag bearer just looking around the stadium. It is an awesome sight. Everyone has sort of torches, that coloured torches that they're holding up. It's a fantastic atmosphere. Now, we love Spain. Spain loves these university games. The country's only ever missed one edition. That was way back in 1961. And this year they brought 43 athletes, a large number of them competing across the three martial arts: taekwondo, judo even, and wushu. The youngest Estonian amongst the team of 15 is 18-year-old swimmer Marie Tumpu from the Gustav Adolf Grammar School. She'll actually be celebrating her 19th birthday during the games. Just the two from Fiji, representing what sounds like the most exotic university on earth, the Waiselle Inoke University of the South Pacific. And I'm told it's in the Solomon Islands. Not sure how long it took them to get here. Another huge contingent from Finland. You should see them at the Winter Games. 102 athletes have come to Chengdu. They'll compete in 11 of the 18 sports, 31 of them in athletics, 30 in basketball. And in amongst them, somewhere in there, is the 25-year-old Juho Antti, the team's only diver, who's representing the University of Helsinki in the pool. The diving venue is about an hour from this stadium, just across the road from the venue that's hosting judo. And judo gets underway tomorrow morning. 180 athletes from France. A large part of them are archers, 26 in total. And apart from 1961, France hasn't missed a single edition of the FISU Summer Games. Strong representation from Georgia this year. Well, since unification, Germany hasn't missed a single edition of the games. 2,500 German students have competed over the years. And here they brought 213 athletes who will be participating across 14 sports out of the 18. And many of them in volleyball. Quite a few rowers and athletes as well there. Let's talk about the cute panda, the mascot. He's called Rongbao. Chengdu, famous for its giant pandas. This is home of the giant panda. And everyone who's come here is hoping to make a visit to the Panda Research Center on the outskirts of the city. No Great Britain this year, so we skip to Greece. And they have high hopes in the men's water polo. They've brought 17 players in Chengdu to try and secure a medal in water polo. It's So back to the mascot and the panda. When we get a closer look at them, you'll see that the whole flame idea and theme runs into the panda design as well. The black patches around the eyes are actually flames. The Fizu Universiade symbol on his chest. And also it looks like he's wearing facial makeup from the Sichuan opera, traditional opera, for which Chengdu is famous for. Lots of makeup, lots of masks, lots of flamboyant costumes in the Sichuan opera. Now there'll be a big cheer for the next team, I tell you. Oh, 142 students from Hong Kong representing their universities across 11 sports, including 11 fencers and loads of volleyball players. Most of them study in Hong Kong. Plenty, though, have joined the team from abroad, where they study in the UK, the USA and Canada. Most of these athletes staying in the athletes' village that's been purpose-built. And I hear it's absolutely fantastic. Some great facilities. And so far these games really have been on a grand scale. In the few days that we've been here, we've had a chance to just look around and see how well organised they've been so far. Big cheer for Indonesia, and they're having a good time, aren't they? More than 250 Indian students here competing in 12 sports. The youngest of the team turned 18 just a few weeks ago. And in that throng is Tanisha Singh, part of the badminton squad, a student at Adamas University. Just 18. Can you imagine how it feels to walk out into a stadium like this and into an atmosphere like this? And she's still got to go and perform. Now behind these, behind this band and on that drum, you can see the Chengdu logo. Again, the flame and the sunbird theme running throughout that. The colours are of the FISU, the Federation, International Federation of University Sports. But when you get another look at that logo, you'll see on the right-hand side that coming out of the red is a phoenix, rising from the flames and the fire of the sun that you'll see in the middle of the U. a small team from Iraq, and the country making its return to the games after 12 years absence. The last time they competed, the games were held in China. The country that has hosted the most FISU games, winter and summer, than any other country. The university games are very much part of student life in Italy, and that's shown by the huge team that's come here to Chengdu. 226 in total, split more or less 50-50, men and women. Italy always strong at volleyball. Easy to spot those players, and they've brought 38 players who are planning to take Chengdu by storm. They're looking for a medal. Now, they topped the medal table at the first FISU games, and Italy have generally been top 10 finishers, and of course they did very well indeed at their home games, the last edition in 2019 in Naples. Athletes from the Miko University College in Jamaica. The Japanese always come in strength, and they're the second biggest team here. Japan has topped the medal table at the last two summer games in Naples. Their 33 gold medals put them no less than 11 golds ahead of nearest rivals China. So it's these guys, this Japanese team, that I think the home side of China will see as their biggest rivals at these games. Although I think China, off the top of my head, has about 100 athletes more than Japan at these games. If you're new to the FISU Games, you should know that students aged 18 to 25 from around the world can compete. And every 2 years, FISU chooses two host cities to organise the winter and summer editions, usually in the same year. There's been a bit of disruption, of course, well, quite a lot of disruption in recent years because of the pandemic, but things getting back on schedule. In fact, the maximum age, because of the pandemic, to give students who missed out 2 years ago, to give them a chance, that maximum age for these games has been allowed to rise to 27 years old. Well, Korea, another powerhouse of the FISU Summer Games. They've just under 300 athletes competing here. The country topped the medal table at their home games back in 2015. They finished second to Japan 2 years later. So you can be sure they'll be pushing for a top three finish in this year's medal table, especially as they have competitors in all 18 sports here in Chengdu. As we watch Libya step out into the stadium that's alight with coloured torches in amongst the crowd, and the walkway on which the parade is taking place is changing colour, designed to look like silk brocade, for which this area is so famous for. And it's an opportunity, let me just tell you a little bit about Chengdu, because it is a huge, huge city, known as a mega city. 21 million people live here. It's sitting at the bottom of a very wide, flat valley. But not too far away is a huge mountain range that stretches to western and into western China and all the way to Tibet. And it is absolutely stunning, the Hongdian mountain range. And the city itself is known as a park city. It's what in the UK we would call a garden city. And what it means is that not only have they... Macau getting a huge cheer and a standing ovation from the fans here in the stadium. So designated a park city, it means there is genuinely so much park space and green areas around the city that it really doesn't feel like it's populated by 21 million people. 40% of the city coverage is green area. It's also the place to come if you're a foodie, the unofficial food capital of China, Sichuan. Very famous, of course, for its spicy dishes. Nepalese enjoying themselves as they step into the stadium, followed by Nigeria. 75 athletes will represent the universities in seven sports for Nigeria, all of them looking to emulate their countryman Clement Chukwu, who set the men's 400 meter record back in 1997, a record that still stands today and that they're all aiming to beat on the athletics track. Norway, normally a powerhouse of the Winter Games, but are out in force as well to prove that they're pretty good at summer sports as well. Five athletes from Pakistan, all of them female. Just the two athletes from Panama, again both female, representing Santa Maria La Antigua Catholic University and Inter-American University in Panama. Peru with a much bigger team. Poland have come with a large archery contingent. The archery actually began today. And Poland really targeting medals in athletics. They're also bringing a large team of rowers and fencers, so really they've got all the major sports covered and are here to do some serious medal winning. Now Portugal are looking to win medals in basketball. They've got a strong team here, and volleyball as well. And amongst the swimmers and the basketball players of Romania is one taekwondo competitor. South Africa. Big cheer for the 164 athletes from South Africa. A whopping 60 of them competing in track and field. And those close-up shots when they don't know the camera's on them is great, isn't it? Because you can just see on some of their faces the complete awe and sudden realization of what they've come to. Eight athletes from Senegal. Just the one female, Fatoumata Baldé. Large team from Singapore, over 100, with a big contingent of fencers and water polo players. Five athletes from Sierra Leone, all of them representing the University of Sierra Leone. Somalia, Nasro Ali and Ali Hassan following the flag and both competing in athletics. Kelvio Soares de Apresentação. That's my attempt at pronouncing that bit of Portuguese. He'll be competing in Taekwondo for the Université Lusiada. And by contrast to Sao Tome and their one athlete, it's Switzerland. Syria, represented by Shams Ahmad in Taekwondo. Thailand walking out in front of all the VIPs and the president of China competing in athletics. Tajikistan so strong in judo and taekwondo, and the bulk of their athletes will be competing in those two sports. Of the 2017 games, they brought over 200 athletes to Chengdu. They finished seventh in the medal table in Naples last time round, but they're competing almost right across the board here. The only sports they haven't entered are water polo and diving. So an ambitious team sent to Chengdu by Chinese Taipei.
Turkey. Many from colleges in cities that have become familiar to us in recent years. Kyiv, Lviv, Odessa National Polytechnic, Donbass State Engineering Academy, to name a few. USA hosted the Winter Games earlier this year in Lake Placid. What an iconic venue that is, with all its Winter Olympic history. A But here they're looking to improve on their fourth place finish in the medal table at the last Summer Games in Naples. USA won 21 golds there. And what surprises me is that they haven't topped the table since... well, I can't do the maths, but it was 23 years ago anyway. Uzbekistan. Working themselves up into a frenzy because they know who the last team out will be. It is, of course, traditionally the host country that makes its big entrance right at the end of the parade.
Vietnam!
Vietnam!
Forward to
just a miracle if China does not top the medal table in 12 days' time. With some really strong nations, with some really strong teams right across the 18 sports. We will have archery, artistic and rhythmic gymnastics, athletics, badminton, basketball, diving, fencing, judo, swimming, table tennis, taekwondo, tennis, volleyball, water polo, rowing, shooting, and wushu. Gone into Italian opera now. So 18 sports all taking part here, and well, nobody's quite matched Kazan for the number of sports competed for in the Asian Games. The Russians hosted 27 in 2013. The trend is on quality rather than quantity nowadays. Ceremonial part of the opening ceremony. If you spot more than a passing similarity in the Olympic Games, it's because the University Games date back to the start of the 19th century, when they were guided by the father of the modern Olympics, Pierre de Coubertin. The
FISU World University Games, Mr. Whiting Hall, and the FISU acting president, Mr. Leon Eder. Mr. Whiting Hall, the president of the organizing committee of the Chengdu 2021 FISU World University Games.
尊敬的习近平主席和夫人彭丽媛女士， 尊敬的雷诺艾德代理主席， 各位大学生运动员， 各位来宾， 女士们， 先生们， 朋友们， 今天我们怀着无比激动的心情， 欢聚在中国成都， 隆重举行第31届世界大学生夏季运动会开幕式。 在此我代表成都大运会组委会， 向出席开幕式的各位来宾， 全体运动员、教练员，各代表团官员表示热烈的欢迎，向所有关心、支持和精心筹办本届大运会的朋友们表示衷心的感谢。世界大学生运动会 是全球体育的盛会，是青年的盛会，是友谊的盛会。在习近平主席高度重视和亲切关怀下，我们遵循简约、安全、精彩的办赛要求，与国际大学生体育联合会同心协力，为共襄盛举 做了精心的准备。今天，全世界的目光聚焦中国，聚焦成都，共同见证全球青年学子 绚丽多彩的青春之约，一同踏上超越自我的梦想之旅。中国是享誉世界的文明古国，也是富于改革创新精神和开放包容胸怀的现代国家。广大青年是弘扬全人类共同价值的先锋，是文明交流的使者。中国有句古话，有朋自远方来，不亦乐乎。热情的成都人民正张开双臂欢迎来自五湖四海的宾朋，向全世界展现好客中国的真诚与魅力。本届大运会发扬体育精神，增进文明互信，为各国青年搭建了无比广阔的舞台。真诚祝愿各国青年朋友挑战极限，争创佳绩，深化交流，筑牢友谊，展示青春风采。青年朋友们，成都成就梦想，让我们一起奔跑，共同铸就辉煌与荣光，合力奏响新时代最强的青春音符，同心谱写人类命运共同体的华美乐章，一起拥抱更加美好灿烂的明天。预祝成都第31届世界大学生夏季运动会取得圆满成功。现在我非常荣幸地邀请国际大体联代理主席雷诺·艾德先生致辞。
谢谢成都，what a day, what a great day to be here today with all of you. Let's write history here in the wonderful city of Chengdu. Your Excellency President Xi Jinping and Madame Peng Liyuan, dear honored guests, dear athletes and dear friends. Thank you to Minister Hua Jintao for your very kind words of welcome. My special thanks goes to the government of the People's Republic of China, to the local government, to the Federation of University Sports of China, to the organizing committee, and to everyone that has been involved with this ambitious project of bringing you this simple, safe, and splendid games here to Chengdu. Fisu says, Xixie. Dear athletes, you have shown great patience. For many of you, your university experience has been unlike any other in these past years, and for reasons not of your choosing. But here we are, finally ready to enjoy these wonderful FISU World University Games in Chengdu. I thank you all for your readiness to overcome all kind of difficulties, but together we have created a games worth waiting for. Dear students, we live in an uncertain world with an uncertain future. We know how much you are concerned by the conflict between countries, by the conflict with our planet and our climate, as we are as well. But as we are looking to you, the next generation, we see great hope. One thing I know we can be certain of is your potential to create better days ahead. I have no doubt that we can build a better world with you as the future leaders. And I have no doubt that sport here can help. By coming together to peacefully celebrate human performance, already you are showing the way forward. Remember that here is too much more FISU World University Games than your sporting results. Enjoy this precious time alongside each other. Learn from one another. Make new memories and make new friends. Speak with each other. Speak with the volunteers. Learn about this wonderful place, Chengdu, that is hosting us. Its people, its history, its culture. Share what you learn with your friends, your family, your fans, and your followers. We may have a global society now, but moments where you can live together with so many young people from so many different countries, even for a short time, are deeply special. This is the magic of the FISU World University Games. To make this magic happen has taken the efforts of thousands of people. A big thank you again to China, the city of Chengdu, the members of the organizing committee, and the volunteers. Dear athletes, in concluding, please accept my best wishes and those of all of us at FISU for the competitions to come. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my great honor to invite His Excellency, President of the People's Republic of China, to take the floor.
I宣布成都第31届世界大学生夏季运动会开幕。
place alongside the flag of the host nation, China, for the duration of the Games.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the FISU flag and anthem.
Sung in Latin.
We
have moved on though. The first FISU Games in 1950, students dressed in
autumn
scholars' robes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the oath-taking ceremony. Oath of Athletes.
On behalf of all the student athletes, I promise that we shall take part in the FISU World University Games, respecting and abiding by the rules which govern it, committing ourselves to sport without doping and without drugs, in the true spirit of sportsmanship, fair play, for the glory, for the honor of our teams, and for the achievement of international university sport movement.
技术官员宣誓.
Oath of Technical Officials.
In the name of all the technical officials, I promise that we shall officiate in the FISU World University Games with complete impartiality, respecting and abiding by the rules which govern it, its true spirit of fair play.
Chengdu Games motto, make dreams come true. And the next sequence is all about doing just that. The dancers playing the part of young dreamer chasers. Dance sequences to go, and this next one is just quite simply a celebration of sport.
performance. We have one more to go before the lighting of the cauldron. And in this one, the dancers represent university students from around the world coming together in friendship, which is, of course, exactly what's happening in the Athletes' Village over the next couple of weeks. Thank you. so to the lighting of the cauldron and the arrival of the flame.
Spectacular view that can be seen for miles and miles around.
Singers on stage, it's a Mexican wave with torches going around the darkened stadium. Sassy, it was definitely flavoured Sichuan province. Hope you enjoyed it as much as we did here in the stadium. It's time for the sports to begin now. We've got 11 days of thrilling action to come. 18 sports across 27 competition venues. Dreams will come true over the coming days. So wherever you're watching around the world, make sure that you don't miss a thing. From me, Alec Wilkinson, in Chengdu, it's goodbye.
Shine. China.